was leaving Walmart and I had a good conversation with some supervisors, a younger one and probably a little older one. Right? Not old enough to say that he's older, whatever, but you know, he's young, probably older than me. I'm 22. He's the young one's like 16. The other one, I don't know, never asked. So I was talking to them about breaking out of the box that we have in our minds and in our fake concept of reality. And this is something I should say to all Americans, really, because the society and the powers that be, racism, white supremacy, have us locked into this box, right? That actually there's many boxes they have us locked into, psychologically, okay? But I'm gonna really talk about them, and then I get to my main thing I want to talk about, my clothes, right? We're locked into this box where you're born, okay? You grow up, you go to school, go to kindergarten, elementary, preschool. I should say preschool, kindergarten is preschool. Actually, no, let me say this. We go to preschool, kindergarten, right? Elementary, middle school, high school, and college, right? Okay. Now, most of us struggle with public school, Israel, where most of us had white teachers, okay? And for black people, this is an issue. Because we know that, I think, what is it, 80% or 90% of the teachers in this school, in this country, in public school, are white female. Okay? And we have to break that box. Okay? Now, society is wrapped into a box where you do all that, you get yourself in debt, go to college, and then go get some job. Right? School prepares you in that box to be a worker. That is what you think. That is what you think as an individual, right? Okay, school does not tell you when that there is no such thing as a box. It is unlimited, right? You can go own your own business. You can work for someone else for a time and then start building your own stuff. You can do many other things, okay? But no, it teaches you to get into the work. This is just one box you have to fit into, right? Especially for black folks. It doesn't teach, hey, you know what? There's multiple things you can go out and do. There's multiple paths you can go out and take. You can go work with somebody and do that for 40 plus years, okay? 30 years, whatever, and then retire, okay? Or you can work for yourself for 30 plus years and build generational wealth, pass it down to your kids or do whatever and work for yourself. Or you can say, you know what, let me work for somebody for now and with the go a little working for myself because maybe you need the experience or practice or whatever it is that you need for whatever goals that you want in your life, okay? Now, this is what I want to say to black people, okay? The majority of us probably live in the ghetto, right? Or in these communities where we aspire to be rappers, basketball players, football players, or movie stars, actors, whatever. Nothing is wrong with that at all. But that is your choice. After you have explored all the other options, if you decide that you want to be a NFL player or a basketball player or whatever it is that you want to be, that's fine. But guess what? You need to break out of the box as is sports, music, and maybe acting, or actually, sports and music are all in two ways to get out of where we're at. That is how the system and the white supremacy has us locked up in the box. Because if you notice, in sports, who owns that? White folks. In music, who owns the label? White folks, especially the Jews. Okay? So we have to break those boxes. If we are to get free and get to where we need to be, we have to break those boxes and open our minds psychologically. And change different things and realize that, you know what, there is unlimited options, okay? The only being that can put a box on you is God. And if you notice something, he really doesn't do it as much. He doesn't do it. Because he says, you know, I got a purpose for you. This is your purpose, and that's what you're going to have to be doing before you even born, right? But he gives us the choice to either serve and either serve and whatever we want to do, he gives us a choice. The system has taken that choice from us. We have to make our own decision, make our own choices, after studying all the options on the table. All the options. So we have to break those boxes. And the box is installing, it's downloading into your mind in that school system. Or in the music. Or in the media. Whatever you want to say. We have to break all of those boxes. Another box that we have in this country. Okay? It's like, okay, you can, if you're a Republican, you have to stick with a Republican all of your life. And with everything that they say. Same thing with Democrat or whatever. That is a box that has to be broken. Vote for whoever you feel has your best interest in your heart. Okay? No matter if it's a Republican, a Democrat, or whatever. No matter race, whatever. Vote for who has your best interest in heart. Not be stuck in this box. We have to break that box. As black folks, we have been voting democratically for the past 50 years, and they have done nothing for us as a people. Nothing. Yeah, they've been doing some things like, you know, maybe doing Obamacare or whatever to benefit everybody, but nothing to put the black community as itself, just by nothing. And we have voted for them wholeheartedly for the past 50 years. So we have to break that box and get out of that box and realize, you know what? Our options are way more open than voting for this one party over here and realizing that, you know what, both parties don't like us. Okay? So why can't we integrate our own parties? Or, you know, why can't we push candidates that will be in the Democratic Party or the Republican Party or the Independent Party or whatever party and push for our people? Because nothing's wrong with being a Democrat or a Republican. Nothing is wrong with that. You know, itself by the name. Nothing's wrong with that. It is the people that are in this party that make decisions. That's important. That is the issue. It is the people. If Mitch McConnell wasn't a racist, wasn't as evil as he is, I have no problem with him. It wouldn't matter if he white, black, whatever. It wouldn't matter to me that if he came out today and said, you know what, my ancestors did this, well, I knew we're not today. If he had come out originally, right, years ago, whenever, and come out and say, you know what, my ancestors did this, and I want to make it right. Okay? No problem with that. Because none of us choose our ancestors. None of us do. His fault, not my fault. It is my fault who my ancestors were. If Manson Musa was my ancestor, great, but it's not my fault that he is. You see, he was, it's a bad thing for this time. It doesn't matter. Not my fault. Yeah, so we can't hold the people accountable for their ancestors. We can hold them accountable for their actions if they didn't make it right. You know what I mean? But if Mitch McConnell came out years ago and said this fighting system is for black folks, it wouldn't matter to me that he's a Republican. I wouldn't care. Okay? If 20 years from now, with a new generation of black folks, if the Republican Party, if we get black folks in there, they're pushing for our causes and whatever, and the Republican Party is the one to rock with, then we rock with it. Regardless if it's the past or not, it matters what's going on today. If that Republican Party, say 10 years from now, we get some white folks in there that want to make changes to this country, and help out black folks as a group. I don't mean it's all Americans, other stuff, and all these other groups, whatever. They can help all the other groups, but we need ours too, right? If they come in and say, you know what, I'm going to fight for black folks, I'm going to fight for everybody, and they name it out, black folks, Hispanics, whatever, okay? And they say, you know what, and they have a history of fighting for everybody and doing the right things, and right by people, by black people, by Hispanics, by everyone else, and they're actually saying, you know what, say they're from Baltimore, right, or actually, I should say Baltimore, I should say, like, I live in Jersey, say they're from Jersey, whatever, and where's in Baltimore, wherever they're from, okay, and they could live in a state where there's blacks, whites, Hispanics, whatever, and they have a history of going to every community and doing something that benefits that community as a whole, right? If they have a history of going to every community, say, you know what, I need all your votes, so I want you to tell me exactly what you want out of me when I go to Congress, if you vote for me. And if the black folks in that community say we wanted this, and that person went to the state legislature or the local elections or local government, whatever, or the state government, wherever they went to, and they fought for that, okay, and they made progress, right? If the black folks in that community say, yo, We're tired of these police doing this. Okay, we're going to change in that. Okay, we want more funding to go this way. We want educational reform. We want to see more black teachers hired. We want funding for our own schools. We want this. And that person went in and said, you know what? They were able to say, you know what? I couldn't get the police thing, but you know what I could get? I got funding for the schools. You see what I'm saying? I got funding for the schools. I got a program signing, you know what? And you guys actually create your own curriculum and teach your children what you want and get funding so you can hire your own teachers and build your own communities up. If that person went out fighting for that, and if they say, you know, I got this for you, I got this for white folks, I got this for Hispanics and whatever else, then I'm cool with them. Because we have to understand that we have to do what it takes to break out of this box to say that, okay, we vote democratically, but nothing else. Or vote or die, whatever. No, that's a motion. That is some box that white folks put us in psychologically. The system white supremacy put us in psychologically. And we have to break that box. If we are going to get out of the system, we have to break every box that the system put us in. Another box is this white Jesus. Okay? Now, see, Israel calling him Jesus or whatever, but we have to understand he was a white man. Okay? He wasn't, there's no white savior for us. No white is coming to do what we need to do for us. We have to do it ourselves. That's why it says God helps those who help themselves. Right? That means that if, in order for the God to help you, you have to help yourself. You are a God. Okay? There is no God that's going to come down here and say, and move something for you. No, you have to be the vessel to move it yourself. Yes, you are a God. The Heavenly Father, the God, the Yahweh, the Yeshua, the Jesus, whatever black version you want to call him, because he was a black man. He operates through you. He will make it happen, not only to see you, but to those in your life, and those that you don't even know are around you, okay? He operates through you. You are a God. If you could come down here, wrap his soul in flesh, right? And do things and build his earth. You are a soul wrapped in flesh. So you can do certain things. If we're made in his image, right? We are a copy of him. We call him the Heavenly Father, right? Last time I checked, every human being on this earth looks like someone in their family. Most people probably see. Probably have memories where someone said, oh my goodness, you know what? You look so much like your mother. You look so much like your father because you're a copy of them. Right? You're a copy of them. Same like you look like them. You're a copy of the Heavenly Father above. You're a copy of the Heavenly Mother above too. Can I believe that? Masculine energy and feminine energy is prior. Notice me, man and female make a job. Men can do it by themselves. What kind of female? So we have to be willing to break those boxes, those psychological and physical boxes. That is why we're not in chain, because we have these boxes in our mind. You know what I mean? This is why we have to break the box and say, you know what? No. We're not going to go, oh, we're white folks, we're going to start our own business, we're going to work together, we can do everything ourselves. We don't need to be under the white folks or under the Chinese or whatever. Why can't we be under ourselves and care about ourselves and do what we need to do to make our places better, our homes better, our everything better? So, this is my message to Americans, but it's specifically black people, globally. We have to shatter those boxes and break the boxes that we're in. I just realized that. We have to break the boxes that we're in as a people. So, let's break these boxes. Okay? Alright, y'all have a good one. I might do come on later a little later. But, you know, let's see what God has in store for you.